Mystery solved.
Oh, not sure I want to know.
Well, I'm going to tell you anyway. Remember the bar where we found my car?
It was the bartender. So I made a good safe choice. No worries.
Nothing's a choice if you can't remember it.
Me and him were friends.
Okay. And the bartender's your buddy, maybe you're spending a little too much time at the bar.
You know what? I liked you better before you turned into such a prude. Why are you even here? Go save the rest of the world. I'm fine.
You're not fine. You're torn up about Erica, just like the rest of us. But getting all self-destructive, it is a terrible way to handle grief.
Thanks for your personal insight.
You know me? We're the children of drunks. We know what it looks like. You've been drinking right now, haven't you? A little hair of the dog, yeah? For the hangover.
That helps.
You didn't plan on drinking until you blacked out last night, but you did. You didn't plan on ending up in some fleabag motel, but you did.
I should have never called you. Except Tan already helped me out once. I've leaned on Luca before. Deacon can't keep a secret from Hondo, and Hondo would have to tell Hicks. You're the only one left standing, so don't pat yourself on the back too hard.
I'll check in with you later.
Don't bother. You already made your point. I get it.
It's no bother at all. What's up?
So, I did some thinking after you left. Like, real thinking. How I'm always the tough chick who helps other people. Helped Erica get dad.
Chris, you gotta stop this. What does Dr. Wendy call it? Negative rumination?
I know. I'm a mess. Vodka wears off, and Erica's still dead, and I feel worse. But I checked around, and there's a community center near here that has a grief group this evening. Could you maybe come with me?
Your wheels are mine.
Yours.
I'll go slow.
Is that a threat or a promise?